In this video, we will look at the relationship between moments of inertia, the rotational constant B, and the energies of rotational states. These associations are described by two relationships. We can see that if we know the moment of inertia, we can easily calculate the rotational constant, and then once we know this value, we can use B to determine the rotational energies. So here are our questions. Let's start off with part A. The first thing to calculate is the rotational constant from the moment of inertia. If you wish, you can follow units here to conclude that we arrive at units wave numbers. The base SI units of joules are shown. Note that we use speed of light in units of centimetres per second and not metres per second. Thus we can calculate the rotational constant B as 1.92 wave numbers. The second step is to use the rotational constant in calculating rotational energies. This simple relationship is shown. We can calculate for J is equal to zero and find that the energy is zero. In other words, a molecule that is not rotating has no rotational energy. Similarly, for J is equal to 1 and J is equal to 2, we can calculate the rotational energies. We can relate this back to the generic diagram for rotational states, which shows the relationship between energies and the rotational constant. Therefore, the J is equal to 1 state has an energy 2b, the J is equal to 2 has an energy 6b, and so on. We can see this is the case from our calculations. In answering part B, well, we can do it in two ways. The energy of any transition is the difference between the energies of the two states involved. Thus, subtracting E2 minus E1 gives us the transition corresponding to 7.69 wave numbers. Of course, if we look at our generic diagram, we can see this transition will have the value 4b, and indeed 4 times 1.92 wave numbers gives us the same value. Part C is a trick question, as this transition does not occur. Selection rules state that the change in delta J can only equal plus or minus 1.